Amid the big-time oil price hike Tuesday, the Committee on Energy in the House of Representatives has approved a substitute bill amending the oil deregulation law. Lawmakers say the law has not benefited the country, and government should still have regulatory powers over the oil industry, particularly on fuel prices, which affect all sectors.
The prices of gasoline, kerosene, and diesel have increased by 17.8%, 26.8%, and 35.6% respectively since Feb 21, 2022. Ganito nakalaki ang price increases in less than 1 month. Umaaray na po ang transport workers natin. A PUJ that uses 25 liters per day and runs 24 days a month will have to pay an additional 11,880 per month. Ang mga motorista, butas na ang bulsa sa tuwing dadaan sa gas station.
Hindi lamang sana amendahan, kundi talagang ibasura na itong oil deregulation law. No? Because after 24 years, nakita natin kung gaano ang napakasamang epekto nito, no? Hindi lang sa ating ekonomiya, kundi sa ating mga mamamayan.
Under the still unnumbered House bill, amendments would include requiring oil firms to have a 30-day minimum inventory requirement per company, per depot, and per product. This will ensure that there will be a stock of oil products in case prices surge in the world market. Kimbo said the weekly changes in the mean of Platts Singapore, which is summarized by Standard & Poor's Platts, a Singapore-based market wire service, should not be the basis of price monitoring in the country.
This is to prevent firms from unjustly adjusting their pump prices based on weekly changes in pumps, even though their current inventories were bought at previously lower price levels.
Another proposed amendment is the unbundling of oil prices. This means oil companies would need to list down in detail how it arrived at a particular price. These include the cost of crude oil at the time of purchase and other expenses like the refining costs, storage costs, marketing costs, among many others. Senatorial candidate Nery Colmenares agrees with the proposal to amend the oil deregulation law. In an online forum marking World Consumer Rights Day, Colmenares says oil firms must follow what power utility firms are doing in terms of listing down the components of the electricity bill. This, he says, will prevent overpricing since the public will know how much companies earn and spend on their products.
Lahat tayo nakikinig dito, hindi natin alam kung ano ang components ng 60 pesos o 70 pesos per liter na charge. Dati ginit natin yan sa Meralco kasi ang taas ng sale niya, tinalam mo saan napupunta. Nag-unbundle si Meralco, di ba? So medyo nakalagay na doon yung specific expenses niya kung bakit ganyan ang presyo per kilowatt hour. Ganun din dapat sa langis.
Colmenares is also calling for the repeal of the oil deregulation law and the suspension of excise taxes on oil, which he says will save every motorist at least 17 pesos and 50 centavos per liter. Meanwhile, House Energy Committee Chairman Congressman Juan Miguel Arroyo says they've called on President Duterte to hold a special session to discuss the oil price hike and propose amendments to the oil deregulation law. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.